September 3rd.
Fox 6 News at 9 continues with Brad Hicks, Ann State, Chief Meteorologist Vince Condella, and Tom Pippin Sports. Fox 6 News, because you matter.
Tonight, the border battle. Wisconsin Governor Walker and Illinois Governor Quinn have taken opposite paths on the economy.
So tonight we're asking the question, whose approach is working better? Mike Lowe with tonight's political lowdown.
From the brat versus the hot dog to the Packers versus the Bears, the Illinois-Wisconsin rivalry runs about as deep as the 200-mile border that separates these two Midwestern states. And 2 years after their biggest fiscal and economic decisions, the rivalry extends to the state's governors.
2011, a tough year for Illinois and Wisconsin. Both faced big deficits. Wisconsin, $3.6 billion. Illinois, $13 billion. It was a problem Governor Scott Walker and Governor Pat Quinn responded to in opposite ways. Wisconsin cut the budget and collective bargaining. Illinois raised taxes, 67%. Business leaders across the region watched closely.
I still remember sitting at my desk going back and forth.
Tim Roberts is the CEO of Catalyst Exhibits, a leading maker of exhibition displays like the ones seen at convention halls. At the time, he was thinking about a change of scenery for his company. He says the Illinois tax hike made his decision easy.
When the 67% increase happened, boom, done.
Roberts moved his company and 113 jobs into a $2 million, 144,000 square foot facility in Pleasant Prairie, just across the border, 50 miles northwest of Crystal Lake.
Taxes are about the same. However, where Illinois is trending and where Wisconsin's trending, there's a huge difference. And Wisconsin seems to be open for business, much more so than Illinois.
There are other similar stories like FatWallet.com, which brought 55 jobs over the border after the tax hike. But the border crossing works both ways. Hotel Compete, a startup from Glendale, moved to Chicago. And a big company Wisconsin was wooing, Woodward Governor, stayed in Illinois.
Every commercial aircraft in the whole world has parts from Woodward Governor. And, you know, Governor Walker came from Wisconsin. He wanted to have them come to Wisconsin. They took a look at what they have in Illinois, all the engineers, the great transportation, the workforce that has a strong work ethic. They're staying in Illinois and growing, 1,000 new jobs.
Right now, Wisconsin lags behind Illinois in the relocation game. A review of corporate relocation wins by Site Selection magazine found that as of 2012, 216 companies had relocated to Illinois, ranking 10th in the nation. Wisconsin had only 57 wins, ranking 24th.
In the end, our growth, as I mentioned before, is largely going to be organic, and we're going to continue to focus on helping Wisconsin businesses grow. And along the way, if we make the case to bring a few in from other places, so much the better.
We're a regional economy in the Midwest. Whether it's water that we talked about a moment ago or any issue, Chicago is the biggest city in the Midwest. Illinois is the biggest state. We've had tremendous investment by foreign companies and countries coming to our state because they see us as a strong economy. We're the 19th largest economy in the world, Illinois.
The same magazine measures states' business successes by the number of new facilities and expansions. Illinois ranks 5th in the nation with 322 companies either expanding or building, while Wisconsin was last in the Midwest with only 43. Bureau of Labor Statistics numbers show that since the big budget decisions of 2011, Wisconsin has created 76,000 jobs, and Illinois has created more than 165,000.
We've created a lot more jobs in Wisconsin. The job creation rate in Illinois is much better than our neighbor in the north, Wisconsin.
Well, when you have twice the population, of course you're going to say that. Our unemployment rate 6.8, theirs is over 9.
And that is true. As of July 2013, the Illinois unemployment rate was 9.2%, and Wisconsin's was 6.8%. The national average is 7.4%.
I do not engage in kicking the shins of any governor.
As Illinois has become the example of mismanaged fiscal policy, Walker is again making a pitch for businesses to come to the Badger State.
Hey, give us a look. That's all we're asking. We're not asking for somebody to up and leave, but if you're close by and you're going from maybe a 20,000 to a 40,000 square foot facility, why not look at Wisconsin?
But as far as fiscal policy, some experts say Walker and Wisconsin are the clear winners. The tax hikes in Illinois didn't make a dent in the deficit. Meanwhile, Wisconsin's budget cuts have balanced the ledger and led to an income tax cut. Illinois has the worst funded pension system in the country, while Wisconsin's is among the best.
We'll see. I mean, our bond rating is strong, our pension system is fully funded, our economy is on the right track, our unemployment rate has dropped consistently, our rankings continue to go up.
Governor Walker says he knows major Fortune 500 companies like McDonald's or Boeing aren't going to pick up and move from Illinois to Wisconsin. But he says he'll continue making the case to smaller companies like Catalyst.
The difference between Wisconsin and Illinois, it's not just the taxes, but it's also, you know, Wisconsin, take the personalities out of it, whether you like Walker or not. They're focused on making a difference. They're working businesses. They're trying to get more and more business to Wisconsin.
In 2011, the Wisconsin legislature passed a bill that gives companies that relocate to Wisconsin 2 years of tax-free operation in the state. Back to you.
Since we're talking about businesses and getting stuff done, that's very hard to do when you're stuck in traffic.
Yeah, or stuck behind a slowpoke in the left lane. Both seem to happen a lot on this section of I-43. It's a tough stretch there because especially there's nowhere to go. The radical plan to change the freeway as we know it.
He used to be a teenage heartthrob. Young girls used to go crazy for him. Tonight, why this member of the Partridge family is singing the blues.